Hello, welcome to my presentation on Bridging the Gap, Voices from Industry and Research on the Industrial Relevance of AI. My name is Klaus Schmidt, and this is joint work with Brigabisa, Martin Becker, Götz Potterweg, Matthias Galster, Iris Grohr, and Danny Wayne. In this paper, we are doing an interview study with a number of well-known experts on product line engineering, and we wanted to understand how important to event like SPLC industry participation and what could potentially be done to increase industry participation. You are interested in this topic? Join me in this presentation. Before I go in depth about our interviews, let's do a little bit of a recap of SPLC. Where is it coming from? It began actually as two separate series of events, product line family engineering events in Europe and the SPLC in the US. The product family engineering events in Europe were mostly driven by projects like ESAPs, CAFE, and families. And these were projects, especially research projects, but with an enormous amount of industrial. There were also multinationals, so companies participated like Philips, Siemens, Robert Bosch, Thales, Telvent, Ericsson, and so on. As a result of that, there was a lot of participation also at PFE from industrial. The reason was simply back at that time, these companies wanted to understand how to do product line engineering and how to leverage it for the benefits of their company. In the US, it started from the Software Engineering Institute. There as well, a lot of industry participation was organized because the Software Engineering Institute as well has strong ties to large industry. This joined finally forces in the joint SPLC series, and around 2011, the industry participation peaked. We had back then in Munich 50%, a bit over 50% of participants. Since then, there was a continuous decline, actually in the last 2 years, so also pre-pandemic, about 20% of industry participants. Now you may wonder, is this an issue or is this just the way things are? Well, some people are worried because that might point towards a problem which is often symbolized by the ivory tower. Meaning academics are only discussing problems among themselves that only they see in their world. There's a lack of interaction with industry. Also, ideas from academia are no longer moving the industry because of this exchange halting. This is not only a problem potentially that could be at SPLC, but it's seen currently on a broader level. Just recently, David Patterson had an article at the blog of ACM where he talked about restoring industry participation in computer science and he was seeing the same phenomenon in hardware-oriented conferences, because he's working on microprocessor design. So it's not related only to product line engineering. And it's also in the broader area of software engineering, people think about that. They both write papers regarding conferences to published papers at conference, for example, really deal with problems someone in industry cares about, or is it just made up problems? And also about other areas of industry and academia collaboration, because of course, collaboration is not restricted to conference. So this is something, and I think particularly because software engineering is an engineering discipline, that is a concern for many, many people. And finally, there's also previous work that we were doing. In 2018, we were doing a literature study. In 2019, a survey study. And then we wanted to go more in depth and picked an interview study with seasoned experts as our approach to this topic. The interview study was structured according to the process you are seeing here. We selected nine experts whom we did interviews. All of them were involved with Software Product Line Conference for a significant amount of time, some 10 years back, 20 years back. And so they all had significant experience with software engineering and product line engineering. And they had significant business experience. So they understood the point of view of industry as well. Actually, seven out of those were at the point of the interviews in industry, only two were in academia. Six of the interviews were done in presence at the SPLC 2019, and we added in three more online interviews. From a method side of it, we started with a structured questionnaire. You also can find this available online if you're interested. And per interview, we had two interviewers. One took mostly the role of a moderator, the other of a scribe. But it was rather flexible, so could also be exchanged during the meeting if the scribe saw opportunities for interesting questions. Also, we then transcribed all the interview material professionally, and then it went through a round of systematic coding. First one also did a proposal for a coding, the second also did a review. And then for each of these interviews, this was joined and jointly refined, get a consistent coding of all the interviews. That was typically done in a round where all authors participate. The resulting interview results were written as a report, and that's basically the paper you find in the proceeding. What are our findings? We want to structure them along three different dimensions. Why do practitioners attend scientific conferences? What? Relevancy of practitioners to scientific conferences. Is it really important that practitioners attend scientific conferences? And third, implications for organizing conferences like this. Let's start with the first one. There were some things which we actually expected, like practitioners would go to conferences in order to share problems and find solutions. They also want to learn about new and promising tools and technologies and so on. But there were also some which we less expected, at least. There's a notion of reputation gain. Somebody goes to a specific conference, will he become more reputable within his own organization because of that? Or is it something where everybody says, oh, if you have to go there, then you have to. So it's not of really interest. Also, there is the question of reputation gain relative to the industry large. For example, is this an event where other well-known and famous companies like Google or Microsoft, but they publish papers? If so, it's more interesting to be there than if it's only small and not so well-known company. Also, social aspects, people reported in the interviews, play a very important role. As quote-unquote herd behavior, basically means, well, you go to those events where all the other industrial people go to. And if you go there, do you feel included? Do you see topics that are of interest to you? Do people talk in terminology you understand? And do people just include you in their discussion and their organization of things? The final point is finding interns, PhD students, and collaboration. This is roughly the set of reasons that we could find. An overarching topic was also strongly visible. If industry people participate in an event like SPLC, there has to be a business case for the organization. It's without, there's no option. And I think that is something very important to consider. What exactly is a business case for somebody from it to go such an event? Another issue is the question of the relevancy of practitioners to scientific conferences. And the practitioners that we interviewed, they mentioned things like, well, if they are practitioners, they can help in identifying real-world problems because that's where they're coming from, industrial practice. They learn about potentially useful research, which they can bring back home. There's also opportunity for collaboration. Basically, that's what we expected to hear, mostly. On the other hand, and I think that's very interesting, if we discussed with, or as we discussed with the two academia participants in our interview group, they basically said, well, is it really that relevant? Do we need practitioners at conferences that are mostly scientific conferences? Because there are other ways to engage with practitioners. They actually do have different types of problems. So actually what was seen as a problem, having not enough real world problems, they saw as something pretty obvious. Well, everybody is having different kind of problems. And there was and they mentioned a general mismatch of it. So that's, I think, something which really has to be pondered if one discusses the relation between academia and practitioners. Does it really matter if they are not there? So here, at least, there were some researchers who thought, doesn't matter so much, at least. On the other hand, of course, the academics who participated in writing up that paper obviously had another position. Finally, we tried to identify issues for organizing conferences like SPLC that can increase practitioner attendance. First is, well, that was mentioned, was to have a forum for practitioners, but actually with research participation, because otherwise that's just a separate event. Very important, include hot topics. Is that really important to industry? Then it has to have some current burning problems in it. And also popular speakers may be helpful. I actually remember I once was at Uppsala when Bill Gates was speaking there. So that's a kind of popular speaker, but you do not have to reach that high up. Another area is the emphasis of outreach. Or to include people from industry, include them in committees. Have clearly marked industry takeaways, clearly written in the program. This is a presentation with industry takeaways. That was a proposal of one of the interviewees. Another mention, terminology issues. Oh. Easy is it to understand what we are talking about for a practitioner? It's not, then it's obviously also not interest. Having open resources, if everything written is behind a paywall, that makes the conference less interesting because it's impossible to share this information in a company. Have clear industry marketing. In order to reach people in industry, things have to be marketed very, very differently from academic conference. And also cooperation with industrial organizations, etc. You find more ideas in the paper if you are interested. So in a final round, let me share a few reflections that we had. And you also find this in the paper. And I should mention, this goes beyond what we got from the expert, also builds on the input they gave us. There are mainly several issues that should be taken into account if we talk about improving practitioner input. The first is obviously, is it important? So when we started with this paper, we thought it's obvious. Everybody talks about practitioner importance, the importance of practitioner participation. But is it that important? Is it important enough for us to make an effort? Also, the group of practitioners, not homogeneous. The initial group were people from research within the different companies. They were often architects. They were partially management people, but not too high up in the management hierarchy. And that's it. You, for example, never had participation at SPSC from your average developer. Just completely outside of their range of concern. So if we want to improve practitioner participation, we need to be clear about what is this specific group we mean with that, and what is their motivation potentially for participation. Number one, which was also made very clear in the interviews, is, well, face it, SPL is no longer cutting it. There were various attempts over the years to marry software product line engineering with more recent topics from industry and also to open it up. But basically, the topics that we are addressing with software product line engineering is not what many organizations see as critical to their success as a company. Based on that, we need to decide on whether we want to have more practitioner attendance and who. And if we decide we want to have more attendance, we should think more about including them. That means, for example, if we talk about program committees, the industry track, ideally should be mostly people from industry. The current, and not only the current, industry track at SPLC has about 1/3 of the people from industry. Then about co-location with industrial events so that people easily can migrate from one event to the other. Have industrial topics and perspectives visible in a way that people from industry recognize as a topic. And have industrial marketing, meaning addressing rather different distribution channels, having reference companies and projects where people say, ah, this is interesting to me. I know these guys. They are doing software I'm building upon, or things like that. No? That helps for people, for industry, to understand relevancy in their own terms. And that brings us to the broader topic of relevance. What is our relation to cutting-edge topics? Topics like DevOps, that may no longer be that cutting-edge, AI, and I mean not applying AI technologies in product line engineering per se, but combining product line engineering with AI facilities and features, and also communicate that clearly, clarify and emphasize industrial benefits so that people out there can see and understand. So with that, let me wrap up. So we think we are basically at a tipping point, or perhaps we are already at a beyond such a tipping point in industry participation. It has significantly decreased over the last 10 years. And it's unclear whether it's even possible to gain more traction with practitioners for the Software Product Line Conference. We found our results based on an interview studies with seasoned experts that gave us actually some, also for us, the author group, unexpected perspectives, both from the perspective of what makes the conference attractive for practitioners, as well as about the question, do we actually need more input, more practitioners at the conference? So it's all about the question also, do we want it? The remainder is for us to decide. Do we want to increase practitioner participation? Do we want to make these efforts or not? And if you do not make a decision on that, that's kind of a decision to give the track on. So with that, I hope to have given you some input for discussions. I hope to see you at SPSC.